बस इतना सा फर्क, धूप छांव में फर्क बस इतना सा। तो बस चलिए फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया के साथ ये फर्क मिटा देते हैं। फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया, 20 इयर्स ऑफ आइडियाज।
Good afternoon, one and all. 22 odd years where Franchise India team is creating difference in market and taking all the initiative for our brands and for our potential business buyers to give them the right platform. We extend our warm welcome to each all the participants to the 46th edition of Business Opportunity Over Chai, a webinar series, an initiative taken by Franchise India for all potential business buyers, investors, as well as our brand. We thank each one of you for attending this show. We welcome our panel, we have Gaurav sir, who is the chairman Franchise India Group, Sonia ma'am, MD Franchise India Brands Limited. And this particular webinar is hosted by both of them. Today we are presenting you a great brand, Flyer Tech. Yes, started in 2016 in Bangalore, fast growing chain of multi-brand two-wheeler service centers. It provides pick-up and drop facility also. And if I talk about their average monthly services given in market, they are servicing 600 plus bikes in market, a professionally managed group. And we welcome Akhil Raj, who is the CEO and MD at Flyer Tech. Thank you so much, Akhil, for taking out time and sharing your journey and your brand with all of us. Akhil, I would request you to unmute yourself and start giving presentation to all our investors. Thank you so much.
Hi, good morning. First of all, thank you for Franchise India give this wonderful opportunity to us as a Flyer Tech automotive operations. So Archana is already told you in 2060 onwards, we'll be starting in our journey in Bangalore onwards. We have some story behind of that, why we are selecting in Bangalore or that. See, in tier 1, tier 2 cities, around 1.5 crores people will be living in Bangalore. And also 55 lakhs in bikes will be B2C customers will keep in Bangalore. That's the only reason in 2060, Flyer Tech Automobiles is planned to be start their first workshop in Bangalore. So in last 4 years of journey, we get it more idea in this particular segment and particular automobile sector, especially on two-wheeler segments. So this idea we will be captured in last 4 years. We will be make it as a good platform, as a professional platform in the Flyer Tech, behind of the brand of Flyer Tech Automotive Operations. So presently we have already monthly we already done more than 600 plus bikes in Bangalore, our shops. Already we are running 3 more workshops in South India, and also we already tied up with 25 plus franchisee teams in all India also. So we can start here onwards. So you can see the slides, actually, you can see the multiple positive reviews directly we get through the Googles. It's around 10,000 plus happy customers we keep in Flyer Tech. And also we are keeping around 50,000 bikes already. We done the service in Bangalore. We have clearly on the two segments, we have B2B and B2C segments. B2B, we already tie up with KFC in all Bangalore segments. And also B2C, we are directly customers. What are the customers they want to be the service? That customers already we are tie up, already do the service. So this is the, actually in slide is clearly mentioned about the positive reviews. Definitely some negative reviews also will in there. But if any negative reviews will come in our platform, that means in Google reviews, anywhere we get it, any negative reviews, it's directly our team will be contact that people within 12 hours will be reached that people's, and we'll be solve the issue as early as possible. In Flyer Tech only in provide in India, we provide around 30 days service warranty for the bikes. What are the service we have done in our service center? We are responsible for that. Last 3 years, 3 to 4 years, we are given that service warranty to our old customers. That is the reason you can see the Google review also. We are keeping more than four plus stars. We keeping approximate around 181 Google reviews. We get it on the Google on, you know. In India, actually, we are one of the top reviews. We get the good reviews from the market also. So here I mentioned about some highlights. What are the highlights we can provide to flare that? We clearly focused on multi-brand two-wheeler service. That means Bajaj to Harley Davidson, all type of bikes, our garage, our team will ready to handle all type of branded. For example, Bajaj to Harley Davidson, all type of branded. At the same time, we are already taken the tie-up with electrical bikes. Now, presently, we are tied up with Ambier. So, Ambier vehicles, electrical bikes, sales and service also will be provided. And successfully, we already implemented the dealership mode. And we have around 5 plans for the dealers. So, it's a clearly flexible plans we are initiated in the market. And every dealers, we provide 5 kilometer territory for each dealers. And our top level management team from IIM Calcutta, and we are already incubated in IIM Bangalore in NSRCL cell also in 2020, and website and mobile application to customer we have last 4 to 5 years we have the experience in the market, around 50,000 plus customers, thousands of bikes we already covered in Bangalore market. We can directly go to the problem. What are the problems we are facing in the market? See, it's very simple. Majority of the market is unorganized. See, 75% of market will be handling in local garage guys. So they can't give the professional service into the market. That is the clearly what are the problem in the market. Then wide usage of duplicate parts. So unquality parts we are using in the market. That is another problem. The lack of skilled workers. Then getting the no transparency for the workers. That means in last year we have done one market study through the IIM Calcutta. So what we get is that, see, every customer facing one issue, they lack of trust. They have some lack of trust they are facing. So that's why we find out that issue also in that segment. Then in authorized the service centers will go, definitely it's very costly. Solution we provide, Flatech provide the solution is a, we provide the professional work done experienced technician in this market. So we have our own in-house team for the training and HR segment. We already connected more than 200 employment, more than 200 experienced mechanics in India. We already have some connections and we have our in-house team will be do the good training also for these guys. Then we also have one AI assigned management system. Our backend system, what are the backend system we are using in our system? All the backend systems we use for the AI assigned process management system we are using, and efficient manpower also we can provide in the market. These are the solution we are provide the market. So customer benefit is a user benefit. As for the customer side, what are the benefits they get from the Flyer? The Webband application, they directly go to the booking and everything. So the initial booking onwards, the billing and feedback, everything will running behind of our application. Then we also provide the skilled and experienced technicians in our in-house team will be do the training also for that all mechanics and all technical teams. And we have provide the more transparency. If any particular customer will be booked their service in any particular service center, at the same time, all the cameras will be activated in their application. So that time we providing a crystal clear transparency for the customer also. Then we are assured about the quality service. So the cameras will be activated in that time also. The mechanic they will get the more conscious about their work also. So that's that segment already we closed. So also we provide 24/7 customer support. Then what are the service as a customer will do the in our service center, all the history they get it very easily through their application. and a unique 30-day service warranty flare to only provide in India. Then we provide pickup and drop facility, on-time delivery also we provide. These are the USPs mainly we are given to the customers. So here I show some value proportions. The latest technology we are using, we want one-click service and service in 90 minutes we provide. Then fast responding time. We have our in-house training center to develop a technical staff. At the same time, we are providing the genuine spare parts and qualified spare parts will be given to the market. And we provide the 30-day service warranty also for the market. Then the next slide, it will be explained about how the operation principle will be ongoing. It's a very simple 5 steps we provide in the segment. See, if anyone required to the bike service in Flair Tech, they can directly go our website or application. Easily they can do the booking. At the same time, the booking will be go for the workshop. The service advisor can easily make the estimation and they can send through SMS or email. And at the same time, this work will be allotted to a particular mechanic also. See, that mechanic easily they can work scheduled of technical expert. They can start their work at the same time onwards. Then after their work, our team will be go for the final inspection of that particular vehicle. And we are assured the quality of the service. After that, only go for the payment. After 30 to 45 days, our feedback system will be automatically follow up our customers and our process will be continue as the same. So these 5 systems we are using in our all Flair Tech brand workshops, we are using these 5 steps. That is the only reason we can keep around 75% of redemption in the market also. So in every workshop, we require some monitoring segment. So the monetization we are doing in our backend system, in working productivity, we can easily monitoring in our backend system. At the same time, what are the mechanics do their work, their efficiency, their service, everything we can monitoring in our backend system will be providing that all technical support. So in professional workshop classes, we are classified as to be 5, the premium, platinum plus, platinum, silver plus and silver. The premium segment we provide 28 lakhs if the investment part it will come. Platinum plus is 18 lakhs. Platinum is 13 lakhs, silver plus 9 lakhs, and silver approximately 7 lakhs investment it will come. So these are the flexible plans we provide to the market. What are the guys, what are the entrepreneurs will be interested to do the tie-up with Flair Tech? We are ready to give the franchise for that guys. If what are the entrepreneurs is interested, we are ready to give the franchise for that guys. At the same time, we have the another plan in the mobile bike pro shops. So mobile bike pro shops, we mainly initiated in cities only because in cities, if we are putting one workshop in a Marthahalli or some, for example, in Marthahalli, we are putting one 30 lakhs investment as a workshop. At the same time, if you have any movable asset or movable workshop you have, definitely you can tie up with any B2B and 1 or 2 or 3 days, we can move this all asset for that particular building and our sales ratio also we can enhance. So that's why we are providing the mobile bike pro shop for the tier 1, tier 2 cities also fully. Then the local workshop network we are using for the spare parts distribution. So every Flair Tech franchisees, minimum we are given to be the 5 kilometer turn. 5 to 10 kilometer, our team will be established one local network for providing the spare parts distribution. So normally if any team will be interested, they will be directly come to as a franchisor in Flair Tech. Their territory actually in a 15 kilometers. In that 15 kilometers, the spare parts we can easily sell. At the same time, in around 5 kilometers, 3 to 5 kilometers, exclusively we are given to service and spare parts. So this is the segment we are using for the, we can do best spare parts selling in that segment also. It's a revenue sharing model of business we have done. What are the revenues? It will come. We can see 1 lakh revenue will be starting from our workshop. That time 25% we given to for the spare parts. Then 13% we want to be given for the technical expert. 4% for workshop manager. 3% for washing and polishing guy who's done it. 2% for accountant. Then 10% for the rent. Then 3% for workshop incentive. What are the guys do the best job? You can ensure, you can give that amount to that guys. Then we can promote the team for that. They are doing the well job after that also. Then 15%, 15% to player cut. Then upper 25% is clearly given to as a dealer. So we are following is one. We are following one ratio is 1:4 ratio. We'll be following. That means every 4 mechanics we have 1 service advisor. So that is we are following. So initially you are starting one workshop with us. What happening is that it is clearly we are putting 2 mechanics and 1 advisor in first month. So each mechanic we are initiated, each mechanic done make the revenue minimum 1 lakh maximum to 1,30,000. So first month they will be closing to 2 lakhs in the total revenue. That time company will be initiated to add another mechanic. So there we will be reducing one risk for the working capital. Normally for the dealership boards, you will be spending a lot of money from the dealer side. So we will be reduce that risk also for that model. See, one more interesting case, if what are the amount you are invested in that particular model, so 90% is converted as an asset only for you. So this is the flat tuck normally for the workshop models, workshop photos in there. So this type of workshop mainly we are doing in every cities. The space will be changing around 1,000 square feet to 2,500 square feet. It will be changed, but it's very cute. And we are keeping our brand at the same time also. Then we have some video also. I think, Archana, we can go for that video also.
Can we play the video, Dheeraj?
Yes, sir, I'm playing it.
By the time they fix it, I will Akhil, use this opportunity to go back to your business model itself. Can you explain the 5 different models which you have?
Yeah.
What is the difference in these? Because this is a big capex investment difference. Okay, let Dheeraj explain. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. A lovely video. Akhil, over to you. You can unmute yourself. You start from explaining on the differences on there is a huge difference which we see from a 7 to 28 lakhs in the formats.
Yeah.
And what is the difference? And it is the number of vehicles you can address or the grade of vehicles or over to you. So we would like to understand a little more in terms of your differentiation of these different models.
Yes, right. definitely we can go, sir. So actually we are doing in five models. Initially, actually it will be investment, it will come around 6 lakhs, 10,000 onwards to 27 lakhs. It will come the investment part. It initially the first payment, first workshop, it will come around 6 lakhs. So 6 lakhs, 10,000, it will come. In that workshop, we require around 10,000 square feet required for that space. We are putting around 3 bays on that particular workshop. So that means we are initiated to 3 classified, qualified mechanics will be do the job in that particular workshop. So then that's why we can initiate each mechanic, we can initiate it to minimum do the service, making the bill around 1 lakh to around 1 lakh to 1 lakh 30,000. So 3 mechanics, 3 bays will be running in that particular model. We can easily generate around 15 lakhs will be making on the total revenue on that particular workshop. At the same time, after the GP, we get it around 25%. And the total HR expense, it will come around 81,000. It will come in that particular workshop. We required 1 workshop manager and 3 mechanics and 1 washing and polishing guy and 1 housekeeping also we required for that particular segment. Then after that, all the dealer get it around the profit. We will be calculating around 1,73,000. It will get it out per month profit they can earn. As that means around with the ROI, monthly ROI, it will come around 28.5%. Then within 4 months, they get back their investment amount. So it will come. So in that investment also, we are making some risk mitigation already we are done in that particular segment, because each mechanic or any single base we will be putting in a workshop, normally in authorized service centers, they will be calculating 7 to 8 vehicles per day is the normal calculations. But in this flat tech models, we are taking only 5 vehicles. So there also we are be reduce one risk. And also in that count, we required around 375 vehicles if we can do for per month service on that particular service center. We get it around 95% of average utilization we are taking, and 356 vehicles is required for to achieve this 1,75,000 profit. So that is the first model. The second model, it will come silver, the same as on. We are adding one more mechanic and one more bay on the second model. That means the base and all the infrastructure, it will come for the 4 bays, it will come. So that time what happened, one more mechanic will add and some equipments and infrastructure will be adding on that particular segments. So that is the difference, it will come silver and silver plus. Then platinum, it will come, we'll be putting 5 mechanics and 5 bay and 5 lift will be on that particular workshop. So that's why again the investment going go to around 12 lakhs it will come. Then the platinum plus we given to be 6 lift we required, we given to that particular workshop in platinum plus. That's why the investment part it will come around 17 lakhs it will come. Then 27 lakhs we will given to be 8 bays, 8 professional mechanics and other equipment also we will be provide that particular workshop. So the difference, the question is very correct. So the difference, what is the difference for the investment part? It's clearly how much manpower, how much vehicle we can do that particular shop. That's the difference actually. So that much money also they can earn particular for from that particular model.
No, very important, and I think for audience have to understand that the business of service runs on per bay productivity. And I will come down to the same. It's like a salon. You know, how many chairs you have, how many people can rotate. It's similarly in workshop also, there's a base and each bay has a productivity. So right. Let's go back to the a little more deeper understanding of the bay. What you said was one mechanic, one bay can do 5 servicing.
Yeah.
So potentially, if we say that a 3 bay would mean that 15 productivity per day.
Yeah.
That if you're working for 30 days, you're talking about 450 total potential, but you're taking a little bit lesser potential.
Yes. Say,
we take it 300 or 350 kind of productivity. Not every time everybody is busy and they have rosters also, they would have holidays also and things like that. If we have 300, what is the average service per service? billing?
Per billing average, it will come around, sir. I'll show that. Average billing, we are taking around 4,000 rupees. So service revenue, normally we will be calculating up to 1,495 rupees. It will come for the service revenue will come. Then washing and polishing, normally we can take around 150 rupees. Then oil revenue, we can calculate up to 699 rupees for the average. Then spare parts, 1,495 spare parts, so normally it will come. Then accessories parts, we can taking each vehicle, we can minimum of 196 rupees. Then waxing, we can add for 150. Then polishing 90 rupees. Then other revenues also we are calculating around 131 to 140 rupees. Like that, if the average will be calculating around 4,004, not 6, it will come. So for a simply I can say, if some workers will come for the 600 rupees to 900 rupees billing will happen. But any engine related issue, it will come around more than 30,000. The billing it will happening. Other works it will be moving up to 4,000 to 8,000. That's the normal variations will come.
You know, my little bit of understanding says that 4,000 is very high for a per two-wheeler billing average. You know, some would come to 4,000, but the average billing in the industry is 1,000, 1,500 rupees. And B2B it even decreases further, because B2B, all the delivery vehicles, all the delivery, I think they don't spend that kind of money. So how is your billing very different? Because if right. say 1,500, 2,000, even you do 3 lakh, right. rupees, 300 servicing.
I got it.
4.5-5 lakh rupees sales.
Right, sir.
Example of 15 lakh rupees, which is, to me, it's too sweet, because 3 months to make 7 lakh rupees, 3 months your money is out and you make for your life, it looks like a dream project. So,
yes, definitely.
How does you justify a high billing?
Right, sir. I can explain, sir. So we already explained in that PPT, we have one model in after 5 kilometer to 10 kilometers, we are connecting to some local garage guys for that spare part selling. So this selling, actually we are connected to that franchise here, their counter selling will be connected to them. So normally if you are putting in the market for a, if any workshop will be starting in this market, normally they can reach in cities maximum on 3 kilometers. But Flairtech can capture around 10 kilometers in that segment. So that's why in our calculations, we are taking same amount only will be taken for that service segment, sir. Around 1,400 only we are taking in that segment. 1,000 service revenue only it will come 1,495. But the spare revenue also will be adding for around 1,495. Reason, that revenue we can get from around 5 to 10 kilometers outside the market. So that's why we can generate around 4,406 rupees as a average revenue. I think we got that.
I'm still not clear, because I think per user revenue, one is a spare part distribution, which is separate, but per user revenue industry is less than 1,000 rupees. Even if you do a lot of quality work, accessories and so on, for it can go to 1,400-1,500, as you said. Even a 1,400, it makes a lot of financial sense. I mean, it still makes a lot of money. But I still have my own doubt that how would 15 lakhs work on this? So I think we need to have a little more understanding. And even the questions coming on the group also are people asking that they don't see people paying for a two-wheeler service 4,000 rupees, especially post the service warranty is over. You don't for that kind of a cost?
We are taking that 1,500 rupees directly. Service amount, it will come only 1,500 rupees. For below the 1,500 only will come. But the every workshop, we have one counter sale segment, it will come for the spare parts delivery. So that is actually, we will be generating around another 1,500 rupees. So there we can generate that amount, because every workshop we are keeping one counter sale department, we are keeping some employees for specially dedicated for that distribution parts. It's not clearly only for not a distribution, it's a counter sale actually we'll be doing in that particular area. So that is the reason we can generate that amount. See, the Flyertech model, we are not showing only for a any local workshop model. We are not showing to customers. We are showing this is the model. Actually, we have clear tie-up within some direct manufacturers from the spare part segment also. So these fast moving items, we can easily put the market and we can capture the market very easily. Company, we have one dedicated team for the dealer development manager segment of that. So if any dealers will be starting their territory of their work will be starting in that in their particular territory. At the same time also, we are initiated one guy for a dealer development manager. This guy will be connected in the local garage network. So that is the reasons we can generate one more revenue.
For our audience to understand, there are two different businesses we are talking about. One is a service revenue, which comes from the workshop you run. And the second business is also what we call the distribution business, which is a distribution business which they run, which is a spare part distribution. That also is an additional business which comes in. That's what I try to understand.
I can add one more thing, sir. For example, I can go to the segment. See, if spark plug, it will come, some branded spark plug, it will come, one name, it will come NG. NGK spark plug. Normally in the market, if any local garage guy will go on for the market and buy, it will come around 80 rupees, he will get it there. He will sell at around 110 rupees, the MRP it will come. So if that same spark plug, we are given to as a franchisor around 70 rupees. So that time the franchisor easily can capture this market. So one disruption we are already do that market segment. So these guys can easily purchase the best quality parts at the good margin level. So that time that network will easily we can manage and we can sell that good parts, fast moving parts in that segment also.
Sure. So. Okay, going further to, you said that you have a team which is very seasoned and we know all that. It will be great if you share a little bit on your management team and your organization capabilities and your structure. It will be good for a lot of people who don't know what the background of the business is and who are the founders, shareholders, and a little bit on the management team, please.
I am one of the managing director and founder, Akhil Raj Dhanarajan. And I'm from in IIM Calcutta. In my behind, actually, I have a diploma in automobile engineering and I'm completing my degree in mechanical engineering. After that, I'm working Popular Motors around 2-3 years. In that time, I'm handling around 13 workshops in Bangalore. So in that time also, I find out some issues in the market. Then after the Popular Motors, I'm going for in Keystone Automotive Operations. It's a US-based company. They will be doing in spare parts management in US and Canada base of operations. Then after in that time, I'm starting in 2016 on Flyertech. That's a part time we'll be doing. We are starting as a single mechanic at single workshop and single system. We'll be doing that. But after 2017, we'll be joining one by members will be adding. We have one more managing director. His name is Anandu Sunil. He's in London. He's doing his MBA in London actually. Then we have the members. We are directly connected to IIM Bangalore. Then our team members will be adding from Vinila Shine is one of the GM general manager in the company and CRM team we have. And we have some dedicated sales members. One Mr. Manjunath, he's well experienced around more than 10 years experience in the market for the dealer development. And one Mr. Praveen is there. He's one of the sales handling in the South region. And every state, we have around 3 dealer development managers. Every 2 states, one of our sales head have every 2 states will be handling on one sales head. Behind of that, we are providing every state have 3 dealer development manager, 1 operation head. Every state, we are putting 1 operation head, more than 10-year experience guy. So that guy is doing the entire quality segments. Every day he is visiting our franchisor and he will be checking the quality segments. If the mechanics required any particular training required for that stage, that guy will be provide the training also. At the same time, we have our own in-house training team. We'll be initiated every month. We are initiated every state. We are doing some program for the quality. So what are the guys, what are the mechanics they want to be training in that particular segments? You know, this is some guys, they will be well knowledge about the Royal Enfield but KTM, they can't do the service. The main thing, they are missing around 10% of knowledge. If they get it, that 10% of knowledge, they can do every brand, multi-brand. That is the reason. So that's 10% our training team will be identified, will give the proper training for that particular mechanics. So this is the normal structure in the company, and we'll be clearly focusing on the quality of the service. We are mainly focusing on the what are the mechanics they want to build a good knowledge of their behavior. These things actually will be going.
Okay, very interesting. So I have a couple of questions, and I'll pass it on to Sonia. You know, one, you would recommend people to start with the lower, the first level, and then they can have a spare infrastructure. Maybe you can start with 1,000 square feet, and you can have another 1,000 lying with you as a cheaper rental. And as your business increase, you can increase more bays and more structure. So that is would be one recommendation. But before we go ahead, some people are asking about a lot of competition. A lot of big players have come in the business. I don't want to name on them, but they are very, very big. How do you see yourself, while you have also a lot of experience and now build a good technology and good capability, but how do you see yourself going through that competition, and how big is this organized two-wheeler service market?
Right, sir. Very great question, sir. So the market is very big, sir. Around 250 billion market in India we have. We are focusing in world market, in especially on two-wheeler segment. So in India, actually, we plan to be capture minimum 5% of market. That is really big, you know that. But we are initiated to that 5% for next, within 4 years, we plan to be capture that for 5% of market. So that's why we are given to the franchisee mode we are starting for the program. And also, we are ready to fight in the market. That is the real thing. We have the dedicated team, our team members. See, one story I can tell. Initial stage, we are starting as a single mechanic. His name is Jishnu. Still, he is in Flair Tech. So we all team members have one spirit. I'd say we are normally said to be, we have some orange blood. So every members in join with Flair Tech, we have one spirit. We are making that. Then we are ready to fight in the market. We are not thinking about if any big players definitely will come. But the market opportunity is still there, actually. So we are keeping our quality behind of Flair Tech. Definitely, we can make a signature in this market. That is the main thing. So we have some idea. We have implemented that idea how to keep the quality. So that reflection, actually, we can see in our Google reviews also. So that will be, we are adding some more USPs on every month and every year we'll be adding that USPs, and we keep it our quality. So quality in our hand, definitely we are not fear about the market. That is actually in our USPs.
No, it's very important. And I think you rightly said, and I like very few people start with the reviews. And I think consumer centric companies have to really see that review is very important. And you started with that, your presentation from that. That's very encouraging, because that's where it shows that you are a very customer-centric, service-centric company, which would bring all the difference, because globally, in service businesses, people who have survived are actually having a very strong service capability. And Sonia, over to you for your question. I understand that you are facing some tech connection issues, but over to you if you can take some questions.
But maybe I'm breaking in between. Thank you, Akhil, for this presentation. I think this was quite insightful. I still see a lot of questions coming in, and most of these perhaps have been answered. You talked about this opportunity, which is very large, and we understand, because currently the penetration, especially for the multi-brand chains or brands like you, is very low, which is close to 1%, and there are many other players also in the industry. So typically, accessibility, affordability, quality, and trust, these are four important dimensions which chains like you collectively bring in as a, I would say, a portfolio of services for a consumer. My one question to you is, you know, because fundamental to a business model is also customer acquisition and retention of a customer, which is today becoming very, very big. And especially when you work in a market which is very, very unorganized, what kind of, I would say, strategy or steps you have as a company to retain? Because acquisition sometimes is easy. You will have customers coming in. Retention is a bigger or a important point which needs a lot of attention. I would like to have your viewpoint on that.
Right, madam. It's a very nice. See, redemption is very important, in especially on every business, especially on the automobile segment. See, normally, the automobile segment redemption is very difficult to get it more than 50%. It's very difficult, but we keep around 75%. The reason how the process will be going, I'll be clearly explain that. The billing time, at the same time, the customer get one feedback mail. So that mail, they can mention about the rating of the service. Next 7 days, it will be activated. Anytime they can change their star rating. So if you are starting, if you are using your bike 1 or 2 days, so what happened? It's normally we can get, if any issue we can for that service, definitely within 2 or 3 days, we can find out that issue. So customer can easily change their rating next 7 days. So this rating is directly affected to the mechanic and the service advisor incentive. See, if any worker have any issue related to customer, find out any issue, it's not only for the mechanical issue. Mechanic issue, not only for mechanic issue, sometimes it's related to any service advisor issue also it will come. So it ratio, the mechanic, this star rating ratio is directly affected to their incentive. So they will be conscious about the quality. We closed one channel is there. The second, we are giving one transparency for the customers. That means, if they will be booked their one service you book in your application, ma'am, at the same time, which service center will be you connect with them, that all cameras will be activated on your application. That means there we also give one transparency. So these mechanics will be very conscious on second stage. See, if I'm doing this work in this particular bike, anytime this customer want to see these bikes. See, in 2016, we are starting. In 2017, we are putting around 2,500 square feet of workshop. That time also, in Flairtech, we are not given a normal service center. They are putting customer lodge. We are initiated all the base we are putting inside the customer lodge. That means it's not deviation in the customer and mechanic. We are clearly open in that segment. That transparency we can show this market. Thus, automatically, the redemption, again, we can go enhance. Then third segment, after the service, the seventh day, CRM teams will be touched with the customer, normally asking for that any complaint or something will be checked that. Then after that, again, after 45 days, normally technology teams, that means in social media, marketing and other segments, will be clearly touched for this customer. And that time also, they will be remain the name of the Flairtech. That's the process normally behind. So all the channelized process, we are tied up as a single backend. We have already, we are running that backend system. In 15th day, if any customer is not connect with us, normally that leads directly go to the service advisor. So if service advisor again to touch with a customer, the customer will know about that guy. So because 3 months before they will be talking around 20 to 30 minutes, they both will be talking. So definitely the customer will be remain that guy. So that the same advisor will be called this customer after 15th day. So this process will be continue, will be going every dealerships. So what happened? We are expecting 75% is minimum redemptions we can keep in our workshops.
Okay, very helpful. Akhilji, I have one question which I will also take. If you can also give all our viewers some understanding on the segmentation of revenue, which can be based on the warranty of the bikes, the type of bikes, brand, and maybe the age of bike. So what kind of service split you have amongst the, and which is the highest amongst all?
Normally the service warranty we provide to 30 days or 300 kilometers. Which one first, we will be calculating for that.
G, No, I think I'll repeat my question. You know, what kind of revenue do you get, you know, based on the segmentation? If I say that, you know, many bikes, bike type, the age of these bikes, and are you servicing only out of warranty bikes or also the bikes which are under warranty also come to you? So a little bit on that, how that revenue split is and which out of these services gives you the highest revenue
flow.
B2B and B2C, which you said B2B also comes in. When you do a bulk contract with a say delivery company like a Swiggy or a or any other player, what kind of pricing they would look at and what is the split B2B and B2C?
I can explain both, sir. B2B and B2C. Ma'am, in B2C, normally we are collecting third service onwards, customer will ready to come to in local garages. So 75% of the customer after third service normally it will go for in other workshops. So in third service onwards, we are targeting the customers. So that time onwards, we'll be starting the paid services. Normally in third service, it will be starting around to be 900 or 1400 rupees. Normally it will come average service cost. It will come for not exactly every bike. The average I said to be, we are doing around more than 300 average. It will come 1500. So general service amount, normally we will be putting 499 rupees for the general service, then adding 150 rupees for the water wash. It will be changing in cities and other outer cities. Then a common fact I will be said, then polishing we will be putting around 100 rupees for that polishing. Then other service it will be adding for the spare parts or engine oils will come. It will come additional charges. It will be that. See, these all estimation normally will be sent through their applications and everything. Normally we provide the pickup and drop service also. That time also we will be send this estimation through the customer and take the appointment approval from their side. So B2C it will come like that. It's the third service onwards customer will come to in our shops. Then the B2C segments. Grocer is asking for the question. Actually, we already handle KFC in Bangalore. At the same time, I'm not said their brand name. We are already tied up with one another team with B2C. So see, definitely the B2C, we didn't get this revenue much. We cannot generate this revenue much. They are expecting their service below the 500 rupees. That is their expectation from the B2B, their expectation is below 500 rupees. They want the service. But the actual point is that we cannot give that in below 500 average, we cannot give the quality service for that particular bikes in B2C. Because B2C bike, they are using widely, they are using their, these riders also using in misuse that bikes. That time most of work will come. We cannot give that 500 rupees service. We cannot do that. We are openly said to be KFC also for this case. So definitely we cannot do that. But every bikes will be give the estimation. That's why we have one separate channel. Directly we are touched to this channel. They can in Delhi also they can find out what are the service will be, what are the estimation will be given. Everything is very very easily and very transparent in that case. So in dealer also in their login they have a separate channel for B2B. If any work will come from any B2B channels, it will come separately. See, in target of 300 vehicle in our lock silver class workshop, our target around 3,325, right? So we are focusing in B2B only on 20% of target. Above the 20%, if we are targeting on B2B, definitely the revenue will be affected. So we are initiated for B2B only the 20%. So if we are keeping this 20% in our workshop, this is the two advantages will come. See, in any stages it will come any month, some months it will be going any deflection on the service, we can keep this 20% and we can keep our revenue as the stabilized. At the same time, we are utilizing one another option for in our Marthali workshop, because in we already around 600 plus customers B2C directly come to our workshop. Then also we are tied up with the KFC. So that time we are given to be the second part-time work will be initiated to the mechanics. Then they will be start the B2B work after the 6. So we are utilized that that space and equipments or after 6. So this is normally we will be doing on this end.
I'll take one question on the spare parts. I see many people asking that question. how is Flyertech procuring these original spare parts is one question, and what is the turnaround time for a franchisee to receive these?
Right. Madam, we have actually in we are connect with only in fast moving items to dealers only. See, main problem, if we are doing a multi-brand service, we are open one workshop as a multi-brand service, we required around minimum 15 lakh spare parts in our inventory, then only we can complete the customer requirement. But here we are keeping maximum of 5 lakhs items. See, that 5 lakhs is clearly on fast moving. That is the only reason we provide this minimum investment ratio in this segment. All other parts, we are connected to a third party in that particular segment. Third party in that particular segment. For example, if in Kochi, we have one third party spare parts dealer. So they will be provide these spare parts. But in our inventory, in our dealer inventory, we are keeping only the fast moving items. But what happened? We can generate it 1,75,000 is very easily, but after 1 year, we will be calculating the yearly revenue, 5 lakhs or 6 lakhs spare parts will go for the dead stock. It will be the major issue. We already seen that issue in the market. So that's why these 5 lakhs rupees we clearly given to as a fast moving items only, we given to as a dealer, and our workshop only we are keeping. Then apart parts, we are tie up with the third parties, and also these all brand, for example, we have tie up with NGK, Bosch, and other brand, or the spark plug also we have. At the same time, we have the oils we are using, Motul, Shell, Liqui-Moly. Liqui-Moly is one of the brand is in top level. They will be using, the branding is Arvon Racing also they will be using. These all brand we have. We already tie up with this all brand, already tie up with the Flyertech. So these all fast moving items we are running through our channel. At the same time, they're required for the additional parts for that requirement. At the same time, we are easily tied up with the third party at that particular segment.
Okay, I think that's very helpful. I think we've kind of covered up many questions. I'm not seeing too many questions, and most of these are similar to what we've already answered, Akhilji.
Yeah.
Is a master franchise opportunity available? Because a lot of people would like to take a master franchise for a region. Is a master franchise available, or some kind of joint venture or investment you're looking at? Because a lot of people feel that they would be taking a larger area or so.
Yeah, sir. Basically, we have target in world market in two-wheeler segment. So very frankly, initially we are given to be the franchisee mode to be the dealers. Then if they will be going there behind, but we can find out that they have the good experience in this market. They are ready to capable for that particular segment. Definitely we can discuss about that. But I definitely we require little more discussion on that segment.
Very interesting. Any more questions, Sonia?
No, I think rollout was one, because we have inquiries coming from many of the locations which are outside. Obviously, Bangalore and South. Will you be open for locations outside, even if it's a unit model, or we only go through a master franchise?
I think you asked to the outside cities opening, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. We before the dealer LOA agreement, our team will be doing the market study. So that time we will be checking if your territory, if you normally will be hold on your pin code. So our team will be checking how much vehicle on that market, how much people should be living in that market. If more than 2 lakhs, then only we are initiated to be 27 lakhs investment also. So what are the guys will be interested to be open their Flyertech franchisee in your territory or in your feasible place? Our team will be do the market study initially. At that time, we can find out how much vehicle on that particular territory, then we can initiate it. So in outer city also, we have tie up with already more than 5 teams. We already tie up. See, the two-wheeler segment is very interesting. In outer cities also, definitely it's a good market in their place, actually. See, the only will change, only will be changes it will come. In cities, 3 kilometers, in tier two cities, 3 kilometers, approximately 6 lakhs bike vehicles, we can get it around 3 kilometers, 3 to 5 kilometers. But outer cities, it's again, it will be changed. But we can travel up to 5 to 6 kilometers very easily. But in cities case, it's not possible. So cities normally territory, it will come around maximum 3 to 5. That is only the territory. But outer cities, we can easily transport. Transportation is very possible. Reason for that traffic cases, right? So the territory we are, we'll be calculating around to 8 to 10 kilometers we can calculate. So that time the market is there, definitely we can give. So before the LOI, our team will be clearly check on your market. The workload on your market, then only will be initiated for the MR.
Very helpful.
Right.
So I think it has been very, very helpful in understanding the whole business model. And but I would just for our audience, some people wanted in Hindi, so I'll just explain. ये मॉडल बहुत अच्छा है. टू व्हीलर की इंडिया में सबसे बड़ी पॉपुलेशन है. टू व्हीलर सर्विस के अंदर सोने जी ने कहा कि भाई 80% अभी तक ऑर्गेनाइज्ड है, 99% अभी अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड है. तो मार्केट बहुत बड़ी है, लेकिन इसमें थोड़ा जस्टेशन भी लगता है, क्योंकि आप नई जब गैरेज खोलते हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं कोई से सर्विस करवा रहा है, वो वहां से सर्विस छोड़कर आपके पास कैसे ज्वाइन करेगा. तो थोड़ा जस्टेशन लेके चलिए. और बिजनेस जैसे उन्होंने बोला कि बिजनेस बी टू बी भी है और बी टू सी भी है. बड़े सिटीज में बी टू बी ज्यादा हो सकता है, छोटे सिटीज में बी टू बी नहीं होगा, क्योंकि वहां पर ये बड़ी मल्टीनेशनल कंपनीज या डिलीवरी की इतनी बड़ी चेन नहीं है. लेकिन अब नेशनल सिटीज में, बड़े सिटीज में तो बहुत बड़ी डिमांड है बी टू बी की. लेकिन उन्होंने अच्छी एडवाइस दी कि 20% से ज्यादा बी टू बी नहीं करिए, क्योंकि बी टू बी बड़ा कमोडिटाइज है, 500 रुपए से कम बिलिंग होती है. और बी टू सी में 600-700 रुपए का जो बिल्कुल लोकल गैरेज है वो सर्विस करता है, और थोड़ा सा ऑर्गेनाइज प्लेयर है तो वो 1,000-1,200-1,500 तक करता है, डिपेंडिंग ऑन व्हाट नीड्स टू बी डन. बट माय अंडरस्टैंडिंग इज दैट इट इज अराउंड 1,000 रुपीज एज एन एवरेज विच कम्स आउट, बिकॉज नॉट एवरीबडी आफ्टर ओईएम सर्विस लाइक्स टू स्पेंड दैट काइंड ऑफ मनी. बट तब भी बिजनेस मॉडल, मैं अभी भी हमेशा कोशिश करता हूँ कि वाइल अच्छा होगा, अच्छी ज्यादा सेल होगी और आप जल्दी पैसा रिकवर कर पाएंगे, बहुत अच्छा है. लेकिन अगर कम सेल भी हो रहा है, जितना हमने डिसाइड किया कि अगर 4-5 लाख रुपए भी अगर वर्कशॉप करती है, तब भी अपनी कॉस्ट को राइट रखिए. तीन ही आपको मैकेनिक चाहिए, आपको क्लीनर चाहिए, बाकी सस्ता इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर चाहिए, तब भी आप प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी कर सकते हैं. 7-8 लाख की इन्वेस्टमेंट ज्यादा नहीं है. अगर आप 60,000-70,000 or 80,000 भी करते हैं, तब भी यू आर एबल टू अचीव दिस बिजनेस मॉडल. एक साल के अंदर 1.5 years के अंदर अपना रिकवर कर सकते हैं पैसा. मुझे लगता है कि ज्यादा बहुत ज्यादा एक्सपेक्टेशन से बिजनेस में नहीं जाना चाहिए, क्योंकि कभी कभी आप डिसपॉइंट होते हैं और करने के लिए. लेकिन हाँ, आप अगर जाएंगे और बिजनेस आगे बढ़ेगा तो और बहुत अच्छा हो सकता है. सो दिस इज अ लिटिल बिट फ्रॉम माय साइड. आई विल लाइक टू टेक लास्ट रिमार्क्स फ्रॉम सोनिया एंड फ्रॉम अखिल जी, आपके आपसे. व्हाट इज योर मैसेज टू एवरीबॉडी?
यस, माय मैसेज इज क्लियरली सर, इट्स वी एक्चुअली लुकिंग फॉर द लॉन्ग टर्म रिलेशनशिप विद यू. सो व्हाट आर द टीम इज रेडी टू एज अ लॉन्ग टर्म रिलेशनशिप विद फ्लैटर. वी कैन इजीली टाई अप विद अस. And also the market is very high. After this COVID also, people will be here about the public transportation. So next 6 to 8 months, we are looking evergreen business will happen in India in two-wheeler sales, service, especially on second-hand two-wheeler sales also. So these all will be directly connected to Flairtech services, our revenues. So we know the market, we are looking the good time in the market. We are see last 5 years in the bad time in the market. So that's why we are clearly making a risk-free plan for you. It's a clear plan. We are mitigated the risk in different stages, in different places. So it's a risk-free plan, actually. So hope we all can make a good India, and we all can make a India, a new age India we can make. I know the franchise will be take a good effort on that particular segment. I'm very happy to join with Franchise India for that effort also. So welcome to all. Thank you.
Your remarks.
Thank you so much, Akhilji, for taking out time for today's webinar. I also feel managed marketplaces are the need of the hour, and which also has a leverage of technology to operate, brings a lot of trust to delivery of quality services. And we really wish you best of luck in penetrating this unorganized category that today is. And you're doing a good job. Thank you.
And very good to see a very qualified man like you, who's a engineer, and I am Calcutta, and now taking a bigger. So this is what people have to understand. Sometimes you don't have to bring in disruptive technology. A lot of consumption is already there. If we can revolutionize and brand it that and create better service through our brand, that I think is a also a great initiative. And you are empowering a lot of people. A lot of people, skilled people, would be empowered through your initiative.
Thank you.
Archana, over to you.
Thank you so much, Akhil, for sharing all the insights about the brand, giving us that understanding. Thank you so much, Gaurav Sir, Sonia Ma'am, for sharing your thoughts, your values to this particular brand. All the participants who have joined us today, thank you so much. We really appreciate your effort and time putting together for this webinar. You can connect with Gaurav Sir and Sonia Ma'am at their respective LinkedIn ID. That's the information at their screen, at your screen. You can connect with them and share your suggestions, feedback, and your issues with us. We at Ventures India will definitely try to help you with more and more information. Yeah, so that's the information given by my colleague Dheeraj. Tomorrow, again, a great brand, JJ Chicken, live for you guys, where you can come and feel the journey about them. I would request Gaurav Sir, if you can just add few pointers.
This is a brand which is coming directly from Dubai. It's one of the most successful businesses in Dubai, a grilled chicken brand, a very, very successful. And now they're looking to enter Indian market with area franchise, unit franchise, and even larger areas, which say somebody wants to compete south. So it's a full experience discussion tomorrow with one of the fastest growing chicken brand directly from Dubai.
Thank you, Gaurav Sir. So registration, you can do registration information is already there at your chat tool. Go to this particular link, register yourself beforehand so that tomorrow sharp 12 o'clock, you can join us. Also, you can call at Ventures India. You can write back to us, as well as you can follow us on social media information about our Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram page, and website of Ventures India. Information is given at the chat tool. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us today. Have a great day ahead. Best wishes from our side. Thank you so much.